And through the magic of television, we have a sheet. So, you want to make sure that the sheet is not pulled tight. Okay? If you have the sheet pulled tight, you're going to do away with a lot of the benefit of the belly board itself. If you have the sheet pulled tight, holding the belly up, why have the belly board? You want to make sure that the sheet itself pulls down underneath the patient and that the patient's belly hangs free. You don't want to create a hammock that tightens up and then holds that soft tissue posteriorly. So make sure that anything that you have around the patient is loose and in the hole. If the patient is wearing a gown, make sure it's on backwards. And then as the patient lays down, make sure that gown gets stuffed down in there. Make sure their knees aren't on it and then it hooked around their shoulders, which will pull it tight. You don't want that to happen. So make sure that it's pulled down in here. That way, when you do roll the patient, make sure that you're rolling at the hips. We've talked about gentlemen treating women, especially when they're face down and especially when their chests are bared. You want to make sure that you're telling them every step that you're about to make. Tell them, I'm about to touch you, we need to roll you. Okay? You don't want that to be a surprise to anyone. So once you're kind of in the mode and everybody is, when you're setting up your patient, the first time you go to touch them, tell them, I'm going to roll you now, I'm going to touch you, or something to that effect. Don't make it creepy like I just did. Just make sure that they know that it's coming. So make sure all clothes pulled down inside the belly board hold, not holding up on the patient. Another thing that I didn't cover yet is the fact that you're going to have an index on the side of the board normally. What's going to happen in simulation once they get the mark put on the patient? You want to know in out right where this patient was in sim. So you're going to be given a number. You want to make sure that when you have the patient lined up, that they're within 1 or 2 centimeters in out of that particular number that you're given. In this particular case, we're lined up with 28 and we're lined up with the tattoo. Don't get too tied up in making sure that you're on exactly 28 in this particular case. If she's a little bit forward and you're not exactly on 28, guess what? It's not the end of the universe. This is a range that you're given so that she is grossly on the table in the right spot, as opposed to 38 or 24. So you want to make sure that you're pretty close, but if you're lined up 100% and you look down and you're at 28 and a half and you're supposed to be on 28, don't reset the patient up. You're fine. This is to make sure that you're ballpark, that you're in the ballpark, that you're close to where you need to be, not grossly out of alignment. You are not treating this board. You are not treating this ruler on the side of the board. You're treating the patient. It's important to remember what's important and what is not in a setup. And this is one of the things that I would say needs to be a generality, but this needs to be an exact alignment.